This is Pop 2, a 3D scanner from RevoPoint, which is currently on Kickstarter, and it was sent to me free of charge for this review. It's designed for capturing 3D models of objects, which can then be used for 3D printing, design, archiving, and reverse engineering. The Pop 2 can scan objects with an accuracy of 0.1mm at up to 10 frames per second, and it captures 0.15mm point cloud data. The point cloud can be converted to a mesh and saved as a 3D model. It works by projecting microstructured light using an infrared laser as the light source and capturing depth information with two infrared cameras. A separate RGB camera acquires the colour or texture mapping information. The projected pattern is not visible to the naked eye, but you can see it with an infrared camera. This is the package that I received. It includes the Pop 2 scanner, a handle that converts into a telescopic tripod. The Pop 2 attaches to the tripod with a quick release mount, and for portable operation there is a phone holder. There is a connector on the back of the Pop 2 and Type A and C USB cables for connection to a Type 3 USB port on a computer. For portable use there is an adapter with two USB cables, the Type A cables for the power connection, and the Type C cable is for the data connection. There is also a black plastic sheet to screen out the background, marker dots to scan smooth objects, adhesive putty for mounting objects, and a gripper bust, a turntable which can be powered by three AAA batteries or USB, and a USB power bank that can be used as a handle or a tripod. Okay, let's have a go at scanning the Agrippa bust. The turntable is powered by the USB power bank, and the Pop 2 USB cable is connected to a USB 3 port on a Windows 10 laptop. Scanning software is called HandyScan, a new project is selected, and then we can choose the scan accuracy, selecting between fast scan and high accuracy scan. Then the scan mode, this depends on the object that we're scanning, and it primarily affects the gain and exposure settings. Feature is for objects with easily identifiable features. Body is for the human body or large objects. Marker is for use with marker dots on objects with large smooth areas. Dark is for dark surfaces or hair, and face is for the human face. For the Agrippa bust, feature is the best option. We can select whether to capture colour or texture. On the top left is the RGB camera preview, and on the bottom left is the infrared camera preview. Where the infrared preview shows red, it's not capturing any point cloud data. Calibration lines on the RGB camera can be used to help position the object, and the distance is shown at the top of the screen. In an ideal world, we're looking for excellent. Selecting clip plane removes unwanted planes like the turntable or worktop. We can select auto or manual exposure for the RGB camera and adjust the manual settings for the infrared camera. This is still beta software, so the auto setting doesn't work. Now we can start the scan. The data that is currently being captured is displayed in green. Once we have one full revolution, then we can pause the scan, reposition the bust, resume the scan. The new scan will initially be coloured red until Pop 2 reacquires tracking, and then it turns green. This object is easy to scan, so the alignment happens quickly. Now that the object is in a different position, Pop 2 can acquire data that was previously missing, filling in areas like the bottom of the pedestal. We can pause the scan again, reposition the bust onto the other side, and resume the scan again. Before stopping the scan, I'm going to pause it and have a look at what we've captured. Pressing stop gives us the option to complete or restart, and selecting complete starts the point cloud fusing process. Once that's finished, we can convert the point cloud data into a mesh. Finally, we can save the model as a PLY, OBJ or STL file. Revapoint also provides some software called Handy Studio, which can clip the model, fill holes, smooth and save in different formats. It's a bit basic, so I think an alternative like Mesh Mixer is a better option. Next up is a Thai statue with lots of detail, so I'm going to select Feature for the scan mode. The statue is taller than the capture area, so I'm going to move the camera up and down to scan it all. I moved the camera without pausing to try and capture the top of the statue, but it has lost tracking and become misaligned. So to recover, I paused the scan and then pressed the rollback button several times to remove the offending frames. Then I moved the camera position and resumed the scan. The statue is moved onto its side to capture the base, and then onto the other side. That's the scan finished. It's turned out pretty good, so now let's convert it into a mesh. I'm happy with how that looks, so the final step is to save it as an STL file. My primary interest in the POP2 was to be able to scan mechanical or electrical objects and then use the resulting 3D models in my own designs. So this is an example, a solid state relay or SSR. The body scans well enough, but it doesn't capture the reflective or dark areas. And that is essentially the problem. Most things that I want to scan are either black or reflective. Here are some of the other objects which didn't scan well. They all have black or reflective parts. Cars, for example, have black wheels and reflective windshields. You can get scanning sprays which might help. Something that did scan well was this Royal Doulton figurine. Soft toys also scan well. I tried to scan my little buddy Denver. It captured him okay, but he wouldn't stay still long enough to get a full scan. Food also seems to scan well. Overall, I've had fun testing the POP2. It's best suited for scanning light coloured objects with lots of features. It does take some skill to capture more challenging objects, and the process can be frustrating. The software is still in development, but basically it works okay and didn't crash. I performed most of the testing on a fast gaming laptop, but it also worked fine on a slow machine. Power requirement for a USB 3 port seems to be the main limitation here. If you're interested, POP2 is available as a Kickstarter. But please bear in mind that Kickstarter is a crowdfunding platform and not a store, and rewards are not guaranteed. Thanks for watching, and have a happy new year.